This is a story of joy and pain, friendship and heartbreak, then friendship again. That's me, Max, in pretty rough shape. Maybe you're wondering how I got here, so let's run it back to the beginning. Six months ago, I was the chief cinematographer and editor for SaladBarz Films. That's just the fancy job title the boys gave me. Basically, I was in charge of supervising our shoots and making sure the videos were edited and uploaded on time. I shot over 50 videos for SaladBarz. Sometimes we'd spend days at a time on set together, waking before sunrise, not wrapping up until well into the night. We worked hard, but it was always a good time with those boys. They really had something special. By now, I probably have 1,000 hours of footage from those days just sitting around collecting dust. It breaks my heart to say that footage will never be seen. Well, at least not after.
I'm over it.
Just like that, SaladBarz, which had become such a huge part of my life, was just over. Some nights I woke up in a cold sweat, thinking I had to meet the boys on set. And other times I passed by old places we'd shot and imagined them as they were all those months ago. I saw faces on the street that looked like the boys. Almost everything reminded me of my time with SaladBarz, but deep down, I knew those days were entirely in the past. I hadn't seen Mike, Henry, or Linus since that last day on set, and I had no idea where they were or what they were up to. Sometimes I thought, I hoped really, that it was all a joke, that they were together somewhere, still making videos, just without me. And then, on April 15th, I stopped for gas at Cumberland Farms on 236. And that's when everything changed.
Hey, Henry. Hey.
Hey. Henry. Hey.
So, do I know you?
Yeah, it's Max. Max, you know? Do you not remember me?
No.
Max, from SaladBarz?
And that's basically how I feel, you know? We poured everything we had into that channel, and we got no love in return, you know? Like, not even the day one fans cared about it. And so then I asked myself, why waste my love on people who don't value it? And I didn't really find a good answer. Once things, like, fell apart, you know, I was in a really tough place. I would lock myself in my bedroom, just browsing online chat rooms just to find any sort of affection or connection, but, well, that was until I found her.
She had me at hello. We locked eyes, and that's when I knew. I had found love. She was just so, so perfect. Her laugh, her eyes, her hair. I swear I could spend days just staring at her. Every time I saw her, it was just like my day lit up. I could be back in my feelings, and then she'd say hi, and suddenly it was like nothing else mattered. Because nothing else did matter. I was in love.
How did I know? How did I know as we flew over a windy hill, laughed in the sun, and kissed the lovely grass? How did I know when I was alone, nothing but a broken man, a wound without a bandage, a bird with no wings? And how did I know as I saw her face in every flower, her eyes in the stars above? How did I know that I was in love? Well,
you would know too. When you can't fall asleep because reality is finally better than your dreams, that's when you know. I love her, and that's the beginning and end of everything. She's all I've ever dreamed of, and more.
You know what I see when I look out on these waters? Not isolation. Not danger. No. I see fear. I see the Vikings crossing the sea in hopes of finding Mother Earth's fertile soil. I see the Mayflower, the pilgrims crossing the ocean in hopes of finding new life, but sad to leave behind the life that they had. I see myself floating aimlessly to and fro. To and fro. And I see you, Henry, lost in a sea of emotional vulnerability, searching for affection, but terrified of the alternative. Now, I too, myself, have spent a lifetime searching for affection, because what else is there when the night is dark and the wind is cold? What else is there to hold on to?
Yeah, amen, brother.
But, Henry, here's your vital mistake. You had love once, and you forgot it.
What?
You heard me. Look, don't ignore the love you have in your life by focusing on the love that you don't have in your life. Sure, maybe the fans didn't appreciate you or all of you as much as they should have or as much as they needed to, but look, that doesn't mean that there wasn't love there. That doesn't mean that your two friends that you were making those videos with didn't love you, and they would give up anything for you. Do you know what I mean?
I do, but it's just so hard to know if they, you know, I just wish I had the answer.
Henry, the answer has always been right in front of you. Look, the answer is SaladBarz.
Hey, honey. No, I'm not busy. So, yeah, tonight, 7:00. Yeah, I'll see you then. No, that's what I said earlier, though. About you. Yeah, no, I said that about you, though.
And it's been crazy. Like, I haven't seen you in, like, 10 minutes. Like,
hey.
No! Ah!
It is May, and the days are mild and still. The buds of the trees are plump and nearly blooming, and only here and there are seen a few yellowed leaves of linden and birch. The wild bushes are the first to bloom, and the forest meadows are covered in newly sprouted grass. In the ravine grow little red berries, the kind that line garden beds and wooden fence posts back home. Whether these berries are edible, I don't know, but they have become my primary food source in recent days. I spend the daytime hours observing the world around me, watching the birds return to the branches, squirrels passionately mating, and the harsh cold of winter melt away to reveal a new life. It is true that in wilderness is the preservation of the world. Yesterday, I built a crude fishing pole, using some of my hair as a line. As I stood at water's edge, I reflected on what it means to take another being's life. I was disheartened by the realization that all life is miraculous, deserving of longevity. So, I abandoned my endeavor and settled to, once again, eat a dinner of raw berries. Experiences like this have made me acutely aware of the forest that surrounds me. I understand my place in nature, my place in the world. And yet, something's wrong. My heart aches, each beat flutters, weaker than the last. I look around me and am surrounded by life, and yet I feel so lonely. This can't be true happiness. Something is missing. I've realized only a life similar to the life of those around us is a genuine life. An unshared happiness is not happiness. Now that I truly understand my place in the world, I realize how misguided this journey to find happiness was. Happiness is only real when shared. I was wrong. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being dramatic.
It had been weeks, and still I had achieved little to reunite SaladBarz. Desperate, I tracked down Linus, the third and final member, and hoped for a miracle.
One, two, three, four.
Thank you so much for coming, man.
Yeah, hey. How's it going?
Linus gave me a short tour of the practice space, pointing out important details along the way.
It would, like, kill me if I'd use it.
It's a nice guitar. Oh,
like, you sort of, like, you can, like, also think about, like, the guys just,
whoa,
just, like, smash it, you know?
Are you supposed to use drumsticks, or?
Oh, I like to use just the hands.
Get that. This is Matt with Paul McCartney. This was taken in September 2018. Like, stuff's going really well right now with the band. Like, you heard us. Like, we sound great, right? Like, we sound great, right?
Yeah, some of it's, yeah, it sounded great. Yep.
I told Linus I wanted to interview him for the school paper. Really, I was just trying to uncover his true emotions about the SaladBarz breakup.
So this is all just for the school paper, right?
Yeah.
Cool, man. Do you want me to play anything?
Yeah.
Do you want me to play anything?
No, this is just a promotional interview for your band. Are we ready? Can we get a sound check?
Microphone check, 1, 2.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
I think we're good, bud.
Okay. All right. Cool, man.
So, Linus, Tecker and the Cavs.
That's right.
Where did it all begin?
I like to think that it started before I was even born. The thing with Tecker and the Cavs is that the sound itself is something completely revolutionary, something we've never ever heard before. And yet, really, it's been with us. It's been here the whole time, just inside of us all. That's all I can really say for that.
Of course. No, that's great. So, for the folks at home who haven't heard your music yet, how would you describe it?
See, that's a great question. And I'd have to say, yes.
Okay. So, as many of our readers will know, this band isn't your first creative endeavor.
That is true. That's fair to say. I have been known to create a thing or two.
And the most notable of those being SaladBarz, yes?
Yes. Although I would prefer not to discuss it.
The band was started after SaladBarz broke up, correct?
Come on, buddy. We're buds.
Was starting the band after SaladBarz broke up a creative outlet in a way to get out your emotions, perhaps?
Look, Daxman. You know me. Come on. What are you trying to do here, man? We're just buds. And look, SaladBarz, yeah, it happened. It's something that happened. And that's it. Now it's over. And I'm fine with that.
Clearly, Linus was hiding something from me, so I spoke to his bandmates to see if I could find out how he really felt.
The origin. I don't really know.
Oh, well, Linus hit us up and said he wanted to start a band, but...
He's got a guitar, so... Yeah, we said no.
But he hooked us up with some sweet merch, so...
Yeah, we'll be bribed us, but...
Wait, so do you even want to be here right now?
Well, yeah, I mean, we love playing music. We've both been... performing and recording music for years. It's just, it's been a lot different since Linus came and he insists on playing lead vocals, guitar, and sometimes drums.
We actually had our own band before this, Family Vacation. It was a two-piece. It was me on drums and Matt on guitar and vocals. We were really successful.
We haven't seen the same success since Linus joined as the tech on the couch. It's been a lot different.
Yeah.
So then, what's keeping you here?
The dope merch, dude.
That's all?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Well, thank you.
No problem.
Well, thanks, guys.
Yeah, that's appreciated. Thanks for having us.
See you soon. See you guys.
Bye, Max.
See you later.
After visiting Linus and his band, Tecker and the Cavs, I was no closer to reuniting SaladBarz, and if anything, what happened next was only more confusing.
Hey!
Wait! Yo, hey!
What?
Dude. Hey, cut the camera.
Why? What do you mean?
Okay, just cut it. Is it off?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's off.
Max, I just came out here, I just said to thank you, man.
Yeah, it's my pleasure. No need to thank me. Glad to promote a local band.
No, not that. I'm talking about, like, I feel like I've just been avoiding it, you know? Like, it ended, it left this big void in my life, and I haven't talked about it or even thought about it, and just, this has been really good. This is going to help the healing process, so just thank you, man.
Yeah, of course. Just, SaladBarz meant a lot to me and to all of us.
Hey, thanks. Thanks so much again, and look, I don't know what you're looking for, but, you know, I just hope you find it, whatever it is, because, like, God knows I'm missing something now, so.
Hey, you're gonna be okay, man. Hey, you're gonna make it through, okay? You'll be okay.
All right, thanks again, man. And, oh, there's one more thing. Here. I want you to have this.
I can have it?
Thanks again, Max.
So there I was. Despite my best efforts, SaladBarz was still as far apart as ever. I blamed Mike for searching in the wrong place for happiness. I blamed Henry for throwing his love away, and I blamed Linus for ruining music for me forever. But most of all, I blamed myself for thinking I could be the one to reunite SaladBarz. I ran until my muscles burned and my veins pumped battery acid. Then I ran some more. Through parking lots, backyards, across traffic, I ran until each tape was delivered. I was tired of failure. 6 months I had spent trying to rebuild what was in the past. I'd sacrificed my own happiness while trying to achieve the impossible. I had failed once, twice, three times, and I was tired of giving up. I was tired of failing. And now, as I ran like a madman all over town, I realized the one thing I should have so many months ago. I could never reunite SaladBarz. Only they could.
How did you get in my house, man?
Don't worry about it, bro.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Yeah, I haven't seen Mike, you know?
Yeah, like, no, for real, yeah.
Like, last time he was just at his house, but this time I feel like Mike's really far away.
Have you been up to anything new? Like, any music or anything? I know you used to...
Yeah, I've been doing a little bit of music here and there, but mostly just spending time with my girlfriend.
Do you have a SoundCloud I can follow or something? Or?
Yeah, it's just Henry Honkinen on SoundCloud, you know.
Oh, okay, worked, yeah.
Yeah, just link in bio.
I have a band called Tecker and the Cavs. I sort of started playing guitar.
Yeah, you just started, right?
Yeah, last summer, yeah.
You must be, like, really, like, good at it now, right?
No, I'm good, yeah.
Like, when you're up there?
No, yeah, Dude, oh my God. Dude, it's Mike.
Is that Mike? What?
What in the world?
What? Dude?
Mike!
Yo!
Where've you been? Are you alright, man?
You okay, man? I'm okay. Just let me get in.
Alright, man. Hop in.
Go.
Hop in, man. You okay, man? Just hop in, dude. Hey, Mike. Come on. We ride together now.
It's crazy. 6 months. I feel like the craziest thing is, like, I didn't realize how much this meant to me until I lost it.
You know, it's true. Like, honestly, I was lost without this, you know? Like, trying to find happiness in different outlets and faking myself, but, nah, I'm just...
Yeah, I know, man. Like, I know personally, like, I was in a dark place too. I mean, I'd say nights on end,
trying to tame that thing, trying to make it mine, trying to squeeze every ounce of creativity I could out of it. But at the end of the day, it could never be mine. And I'll tell you, boys, I was in a dark place. A place so terrible, I...
Oh, are you okay?
Dude, Mike.
Are you okay, man?
Yeah, I am a man, 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 up in the air. And I run around, round, round, round.
You know what this reminds me of? You guys remember when I was like locked in my basement and I was gaming? You guys came and saved me.
You don't need to explain if everything's changed. Just know I'm just like you.
I don't even understand how we found you. Like, were you in like this part of the country, or were you?
I was in Alaska.